And now, once they see the cabinet budget, it appears in their amendments. Imagine where we would be then, or imagine where that 2,700 people less than 21,000 would be now if the Labour Party was still able to go forward. Don't say it wasn't rushed, it was rushed. Normality, though, bears its head in the approach, I must say, taken by the new leader. In its way for a leader not bound by the coalition agreement to attempt to engage with other parties and to seek to be inclusive. It is a welcome change in approach and one that should be taken forward into the future. It's not actually unusual in other balanced councils, of course, for the leader to seek agreement on the content of the budget. Sefton does it every year, and other council leaders up and down the country engage. Only on Bill, in fact, is it thought to be strange, an example perhaps of what is normal elsewhere being considered abnormal here. Complete agreement, however, has eluded us, and the council agree, shouldn't worry himself over that. It's no reflection on what he attempted to achieve. And I don't believe it's in the nature of politics, and we will vote tonight on those issues. In the amendments that we've moved, we try to encapsulate those differences. On the rebate, we're convinced the rebate is right. The release of huge sums from reserves can have a stabilising effect on the revenue budget. They can't be used for one-off pieces of expenditure. The sums were released because they were amassed against the risk of liability that has not materialised. We agree with returning that money to the people from whom it came. But what's the best way of doing it? We maintain that fairness should win out. We maintain that we can use this windfall as a stimulus to the local economy, something Ed Balls have been talking about recently. A stimulus would work best if money is targeted towards the most people. That's why we opted for the fixed sum of £30, because when compared to across the board 3% the 90% of dwellings that are in bands 8 to 8 will receive more money than the wealthier 10% of our population that live in bands E to H. Simple as that. And I'm afraid I don't understand why the other two parties can't see that. Like John Hale, I'm also pleased to see additional money to forums for local priorities and local issues identified through neighbourhood plans. The question arises again in our mind. What is the fairest way of distributing that money? An element of equal shares is obviously important, but we also seek to target some based on need. Previously, funding streams have aimed to tackle need have had something of an all or nothing approach, ignoring the sort of pockets of deprivation that we can identify in low super output analysis. Allocating a small portion of the funding that's been made available on identified need ensures all forums will receive a fair share in tackling that. And amid the diversity of will, from the shipyards and the terraces in the east to the farms and cottages of the west, are what make will attractive to us. However, it also means that the solutions and priorities can be completely different. And amid in conclusion, the golden thread that links our amendments is fairness. This budget council is the final arbiter of budgetary policy, and in reality, it now falls to Labour to decide between us on these issues. They may have advocated their responsibilities for empty chairs at the cabinet, but here in this chamber they do need to decide